It's widely acknowledged that it's mainly highly developed musicians that have found a home on the roster of Warp Records. Thus, it's not really surprising to find that the Australians behind PVT are signed to the label. The trio, who started out under the name of Pivot, actually had to change their name due to a legal dispute with a metal band of the same name. But this didn't affect them musically, and certainly not for the worse. Far from it, in fact. With the use of Richard Pike's voice on their last album, titled Church With No Magic, their songs have gained an extra dose of their somewhat undefinable emotional side, something that makes PVT's sound unmistakable. What's definitely remained is the experimental and improvisational character of their music.
We come from an improvisational background, both me in electronics and the other guys with their traditional instruments, that's where the band originated from, like, I guess a jam band, and we would create songs from that. And this new record, we kind of started off doing that, but the introduction of a voice was a new thing, where we started using the voice as an improvisational instrument as well.
I guess the album did come out quite dark and noirish, but that was something that we were just interested in sonically and feeling-wise. We wanted to go down that path. We were listening to a lot of stuff that had that sound and feel and mood, but also we were just feeling that way and wanted to express something emotionally that was black, you know. We didn't want to do something throwaway and happy and smiley. We were interested in something of substance, and that really does fit in with the ideas of the lyrics.
Und jetzt sind wir schon mittendrin im PVT-Universum. This time you are, I think, more focused on the vocal side of your music. Did it go by chance, or is it something that you're really focused on?
It was something that developed while we were writing, so for us it was pretty natural, but maybe for a lot of listeners it's quite sudden.
How do the people react on it? So
pretty good. I think so. I was expecting a far more negative reaction, actually. Mm-hmm. And it's been quite positive.
Yeah. So what a surprise.
I think our ambition is always to have our own sound. I think that's where the whole process is, a search for that. You know, I guess we have influences, but we don't try and think of them so directly, you know. I think we're always trying to expand what we do. I mean, in some ways I feel like that's our obligation, you know, as musicians, is to kind of, that our music should be an ongoing proposition, you know. It shouldn't just be about cutting ourselves into a shape and then always fitting into the right hole, you know. We don't really see the point in that for us or for anyone. Playing live is a very important aspect of what we do, and it has become more so over the last 2 years because we've performed continually so much. We've done, you know, more gigs in the last few years than we ever have in our lives before. So that's an important aspect of what we do, and that ties into how this new album came about. We wanted it to sound quite live, and we wanted the drums to sound roomy, and we wanted the vocals to have, you know, a nice reverb on it, and we wanted things to sound visceral and energetic. So that whole live element is, yeah, very important for PVT.
Live sound and live performance is really, I mean, obviously really important for us, and to have a physical reaction to music I love that's the, like they're the things that are most memorable about live performance, where you really feel for either from the sound or from the performance or both, you know. And if people get that from our shows, then you know I'm happy.
For me, musical expression has always started with the drum kit, you know, from a very early age. And I've used that in a number of different ways and a number of different styles. But for me, that's the purest form of musical expression, even just doing it by myself. I think when you do a lot of shows, you personally want to enjoy it. You personally want to get something from it rather than just playing your parts and hoping people enjoy it. So the more important thing for us is just to make sure that we have fun on stage, you know. There is an element of joy in what we do. Even though the songs might seem dark and brooding and moody, we perform them with joy and abandon, hopefully. I think we're always very wary of like trying to explore things unconsciously, you know. I don't know what it is about our background that makes us quite inquisitive, you know, like we want to find something unknown, you know, all the time, like explore a space which is unknown to us, you know. The emotional side of what we do, I think, has always been there regardless of adding vocals or not. I guess it becomes more prominent when a voice is attached to it. People have an instant attachment to the voice and it instantly gives music a face or a kind of human quality that instruments can never give. There's this instantaneous thing that human ear picks up on voice a lot quicker than anything else, I suppose. So from our perspective, it's not a big transition. We're still making music the same way we always did, except now we've added in the element of words. I think we try and make records that may hold up in some way. And when we were making this record, I felt like I didn't really know exactly what we were doing, which I think is always an encouraging feeling. Like, I think if you understand too clearly what it is you're doing, then it means you're probably not taking enough risks, you know. So I think we were more than prepared for the idea that maybe some of the results wouldn't be successful, you know, but it was something we had to do regardless. The most encouraging thing, I think, the most exciting thing about this record is the feeling I get in terms of the prospects for what we can do next. I feel like when we made a record like O Soundtrack My Heart, something that happened very quickly, you know, over a period of really only a handful of months, you know, 4 to 6 months from beginning to end, and it was a very new process for us as a group. People seem to want to pigeonhole you into doing that thing, but that was one small period in our existence. And we're at this point, and then we're moving on here, but people become fixated with this point back here, and it's like, it almost creates this feeling that you're not allowed to move past. You have to exist in this point forever, which is a ridiculous concept, really. It's like someone saying you have to be 16 years old forever, you know what I mean? Or you always have to like The Simpsons, you know, and always find it funny, which some people do, but I don't, but that's another story. As far as production goes, we try to keep the mistakes and keep the live elements of the recording. So there'd be times where in the jams I would put a huge, ridiculous like delay on something, on Lawrence's drums or something, and it sounded really overbearing, but we kept it because that's what I do live, and we wanted to have that element of spontaneity and you know, instinctual things. And I guess for the like the change from A Soundtrack in My Heart to Church of No Magic, that's probably it, in that there's a big element of having played live together for so long. It sounds like a band on stage in some ways, because it's very of the moment. Never in my own life. I think in the long run, I would hope that, you know, our ambition is to create a body of music over a period of time, and that it will be interesting as a body of music. You know, it's not something that we need to necessarily be fashionable, you know, or immediately understood, but we just have to do what we do and stay focused on that. That's all that really matters, you know, how we feel about it and whether we can sleep at night, that's fine. I think sometimes people think we're quite dark and brooding and so forth, but I think one thing is we all have quite a strong sense of humour, and sometimes people don't understand that. Although our music is moody, we do like to laugh a lot, particularly on tour.
Good night, see you soon.